my fellow Hufflepuffs in the other uncooler houses. I'm just kidding. Come back, come back. Gryffindor, Slytherins, Ravenclaws, come back. We're all friends here. I'm just playing. We can have fun together. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Since I recently discovered that I'm a Hufflepuff and proud of it, I want to figure out who else is a Hufflepuff. Not real people because, you know, social interactions. I'm not about that. I want to hang out with cartoons because cartoons are so much better in real life. But, yeah, I see these type of videos on YouTube all the time. My arms are getting tired. I'm sorry. Where people would say a character's name and debate if they belong in a certain house or not. But instead of having a debate, I'm just going to be here by myself because, you know, I typically am. And I'm going to just do the research and try to figure out, are they really a Hufflepuff or do they belong in another house? Now, my goal is to prove that they are a Hufflepuff. But if I find a reason that they aren't a Hufflepuff, I will admit it. Admit defeat, unfortunately. But yeah, for episode 1, we are going to start with Phineas Flynn from Disney's Phineas and Ferb, one of my favorite cartoons, as I'm sure as it is for other viewers. So, let's begin, but first, we need to ask the question, is he a Hufflepuff? Let's figure it out together.
So our choice is to either forget the best day ever, forget the biggest adventure we've ever had, and forget meeting Agent P, or remember today, but never see Perry again?
Well, we've had a lot of great days, but we only have one Perry.
Agreed.
Yeah!
Now, at first glance, you could argue that both Phineas and Ferb are Ravenclaws with their intelligence and creativity with all the inventions they made over the longest summer in history. But with his intelligence aside, Phineas can be a bit slow when it comes to the obvious. For example, Isabella's crush on him. Now, Hufflepuffs aren't the brightest and they tend to miss things quite a bit. And for Phineas to not see that Isabella is clearly crushing on him, yo, that sounds like a Hufflepuff move to me. And also, let's look at all the inventions that Phineas has made over the summer. He did it to have fun. If a Ravenclaw did all those inventions, they would probably do it to succeed in life or impress someone, maybe someone like in a high college, if we're talking the Muggle world and not the Harry Potter world. Phineas made all those inventions just to have fun. And he did not exclude anyone. He included everyone, his friends, his neighbors, even his family. Every day, he asks Candace if she wants to play with them. And of course, she refuses and threatens to tell their mom on him. And does Phineas get upset? No, because he didn't think what he's doing is wrong. He thinks it's fun and he's glad that Candace wants to tell his mother. He wants her to see all their inventions. But realistically, if she did, they would so get grounded. Let's be real. I mean, building a skyscraper to the moon? Come on. Yeah, you would not approve your child of doing that. And let's just talk about the Hufflepuff qualities. There's hardworking. Clearly, Phineas is very hardworking throughout the summer. He never once got bored, except for a brief moment in the first episode, and never again. And they're loyal. Like I said earlier, he always includes everyone, as many people as he can. He never backstabbed them or used them to get what he wants. He's a very honest person. And he's very fair. And you can see this in the first appearance of Phineas in the first episode of the show, where they made the roller coaster and someone asked him if they could go again. And Phineas very kindly and respectfully declined, saying, only one ride per customer. That sounds fair, and he was nice about it. Sounds very Hufflepuff, honestly. Now, I'm not saying Ravenclaws can't be fair or know how to have fun. Of course they do. I'm just saying, Ravenclaws tend to get caught up in their work, and they want to focus on their work, and sometimes nothing else. Sometimes. This doesn't apply to all of them. Some of them, this does apply. But Phineas, even when he's in the middle of a project, he will put down everything if someone else needs his help. And we see this throughout the show. Either Isabella, Buford, Baljeet, Candace, they come up to him in the middle of a project and says, "Phineas, I need your help." He's like, "Well, I was going to do this, but sure, I'll be happy to help you." That's so Hufflepuff! All Hufflepuffs are eager to help people. As I keep mentioning, Phineas does the inventions for fun. He doesn't do it to compete or prove that he's better than everyone else. In one episode called Thaddeus and Thor, two boys named Thaddeus and Thor try to show up Phineas and Ferb, saying that they're better at building things than they are. Phineas and Ferb, not being the competitive type, are just excited to have some fun. And they do end up winning, but they don't brag about it, which kind of sounds like a Gryffindor thing to do if you do brag about something you're good at. Phineas, he knows he's good at it, but he doesn't brag about it. And he even acknowledges someone else's work if they did a good job. Even though Phineas's tower is clearly better than Thaddeus and Thor's tower, it was a tower building episode, by the way, he acknowledged that they had something that they excluded, and that was a nice touch. How Hufflepuff of you, Phineas. Now, after all my research, I've concluded that Phineas has Hufflepuff qualities along with Ravenclaw qualities, and honestly, I can see him in both houses. If there's like a combination house of the two, he would probably go there. But I want to hear from you guys. Do you prefer Phineas as a Ravenclaw, or did I make a valid argument that he's a Hufflepuff and you believe in that argument? Let me know in the comments down below, and mention a character you want me to do research on and see if they're also a Hufflepuff. You guys do that, and I'm going to go in the Hufflepuff corner room and get some food, okay? I'll see you guys later.